A very good morning to all of you. I hope all of you are good and safe at home. So in the last part of the video, we had discussed about your balance in nature. Okay, that you need both plants and animal to maintain a balance of life on the earth. Okay, now we will reach to our checkpoint number 3. Okay, that is fill in the blanks. Okay, first we will do that. So that is your checkpoint number 3, that is your fill in the blanks. Okay, so your first question is, the energy of the dash flows to plants and then to animals. The energy of the dash flows to plants and then to the animals. What will be the answer here? Yes, sunlight. Okay, the energy of the sunlight flows to plants and then to the animals. Plants use the sunlight to prepare the food. Okay, and the plant, the food which is prepared by the plant, okay, that is eaten by the animal. So that's how. Next is, plant take in dash and given out dash into air during photosynthesis. So in the process of photosynthesis, plant takes carbon dioxide and give out oxygen into air. Balance in nature is maintained by both plant and animal. Okay, now come, that is your checkpoint number 3 which we had completed. Now come to your next section, that is I wish I knew. Okay, you know, when there is a rainy season, then you will found out that there are items which is made up of leather, such as your belt and shoes. Then you find out that sometime a white cotton like substance is found growing on these items. And you know what, this white cotton like substance is also a type of fungus. Okay, now next is your I think and reflect section. You have to, there is given 3 options. Okay, your statement is, which of the following can make their own food? Water lily, mushroom, sugar cane. So what will be the answer here? Yes, your sugar cane. Now next to your I link section. Okay, you know, when the International Earth Day celebrated, it is celebrated on the 22 April. Okay, you know, Earth is called Mother Earth in many countries, even in India also. Okay, you know, this symbolizes your interdependence between human beings and other animals and the plants present on the earth. Means your humans, your animals and plants are dependent on one another. Okay, so this day is celebrated. That is on 22 April. International Mother Earth Day. Okay. Now next is your I observe section. So, if you have taken a tiny sample of raw potato in one bowl and a tiny sample of cooked potato in another bowl, okay, then just put a few drops of iodine on the top of samples. Okay, so if you put a few drops of iodine on the top of the sample, then what happens? You know, the starch present in the potato react with the iodine, turning it blue in color. You know, your cooked potato turn darker blue than uncooked sample. You know why? Because cooking helped to break down the cell wall of the food item and release the starch stored within it. Okay, you can also check other vegetables for the presence of starch too. Like you can also check the rice if you want to check the presence of the starch. Okay, so that is your I observe section. Now next is your I extend section. Okay, if you take a potted plant with green leaves and keep it in a dark room for about 48 hours. And now if you pluck a leaf from this plant and test it for starch, then what do you observe? Okay, the leaf dash starch. Leaf contain your starch or does not contain? Explain why. If you take a potted plant, okay, with green leaves and keep it in a dark room for 48 hours, then what happen? It will contain a leaf, it will contain starch or not? Yes, it will not contain starch, okay? Because we had kept it in a dark room where there is no sunlight. If there is no sunlight, then how the leaf prepare the food? So it does not contain your starch, okay? Next is, you have learned that plants are extremely important for us. Why they are important for us? They provide us food and oxygen. So you have to plant a tree in your home. Try to plant a tree in your home, okay, or nearby garden, so that it can support the environment. So that is your third chapter. So we had completed your third chapter, that is leaves, the food factory of the plant. In this chapter we had discussed about your parts of the leaf. Then we came to learn about that how plant prepare their food. We came to learn about that your animals depend on the plants, and plant depend on the animals and maintain the balance of life on this earth. We learn about that we have to plant plant the trees, okay. We have to save the plants because we directly or indirectly depend upon the plants for our food. So that's all what we had discussed. So thank you and have a nice day.